Welcome to my science cafe. Now, what about this lecture? This lecture is very important from the point of view of your examination, because in examination you will be asked to draw the structures on the basis of hybrid orbital theory. You will be given any compound like methane, ammonia, water, any compound will be given, and you will be asked to draw the hybrid orbital theory structure of that compound. So first of all, how can we identify which compound undergo which type of hybridization, either it is sp3, sp2 or sp. The main purpose of this lecture is to identify the compound with a type of hybridization. When you will be able to identify the type of hybridization, it will be a child's play to draw the structure. So without any further ado, let's start our lecture. So now students, let's start. First of all, let's take an example. We are taking the compound methane. As you all know, methane is also known as marsh gas. First of all, draw a structural formula of methane. Carbon is the center atom and 4 hydrogen are single covalently bonded with carbon. Now, I told you how to identify what is sigma bond and what is pi bond. If you have not seen my lecture number 1, there is a link below, I am sharing in the YouTube card, you can see it. So, I told you that sigma bond is a single covalent bond or the first bond that is formed between the atoms in a chemical reaction. So, can you count the number of single covalent bond here? Yes, there is 1, 2, 3 and 4. We have 4 single covalent bond, that is we have 4 sigma bonds. That is the first thing that we need to identify in a structure or a compound. Now tell me how many sigma bonds, then how can we identify by knowing that the number of sigma bonds is 4, how can we identify which type of hybridization is this? Just minus 1 from the number of sigma bonds, that is if we have 4 sigma bonds, minus 1 will be the type of hybridization you will be having in your compound. 4 minus 1, you will be getting 3. It means that you will be having sp3 hybridization in methane. I am writing an abbreviation of it just to save your time. Getting my point? Just review again. Count the number of single covalent bond, that is sigma bond, in a compound. Here we have 1, 2, 3 and 4 single covalent bond, that is we have 4 sigma bond. Just one less than the number of sigma bond, we will be having the type of hybridization in a compound. Now that we have identified which type of hybridization is occurring in a compound, that is our compound here is methane, it's time for us to think about what is central atom, because the sigma bond that we will be counting will be of a central atom. So how can you identify which is the central atom in a compound? So there are two logics for it. Number one is that element which is least in number is your central atom. Here we have 1 carbon and 4 hydrogen. So definitely carbon is our central atom. Now the second point is that if you are given a compound which is ethyl, C2H2, here we have same number of carbon and same number of hydrogen. So what will you do? Now the second logic will work here. Element which has greater atomic number. As you all know, carbon has 6 atomic number and hydrogen has only 1 atom in its outermost shell. So clearly from here, carbon is your central atom. Now that I hope that you guys have really understood what the central atom is, and if you have any query you can comment in the section below. Now we will move towards the structure. First of all, there will be case that we will be drawing this structure of compound. You can write it in the sentence. You have to write all the key points that I am writing here in a sentence for examination point of view. Methane. First of all, identify which is central atom, and we have identified central atom is our carbon, as it is least in number. So central atom is carbon. Second point will be coming here is that draw the structural formula of methane. Structural formula of methane. Do remember, carbon has a valency of 4 electrons. If you are struggling or getting puzzled by identifying what is the valency number of different compound, different element, I will be doing a lecture video on it, in which I will be telling you about how to identify the group, period and valency of different elements. So for the time being, just remember carbon has 4 valency, or I can tell you about that. If you think about carbon, it has 6 atomic number. Getting my point? 6 atomic number. If you write the electronic configuration, it will be K shell has only 2 capacity of electrons, so 2 will be given to the K shell, 2 electrons. L shell will be having 4 plus 2, 6. So how many electrons do carbon need to complete its outermost shell? Here outermost shell of carbon is L shell. So how many electrons do it need to complete its outermost shell? It needs 4 more electrons to complete its octet, 4 more. So 4 is the valency of carbon. The number of electrons required to complete an octet is many of the times is the valency number. So here we can see that carbon has 4 valency. Now that was something out of the topic. I will be doing a lecture video on it, don't worry about it. Now count the number of sigma bonds. That is single covalent bond, 1, 2, 3, 4. Write the sigma bond. We have 4 sigma bonds here. As I told you, just one less than the number of sigma bond will be the type of hybridization you will be having in your compound. So one less than 4 is sp3. It is sp3 hybridized orbital. You're writing a short form on it. 4s4 sigma bonds means one less than 4 sp3 hybridization. Now there is nothing left. Write the geometry of the compound. Geometry will be the same. What will be the geometry? Sp3 hybridized is always tetrahedral. Write tetrahedral. Sorry about the markers. I hope you can see tetrahedral here. Now the bond angle. Bond angle. In very first lecture video, I have told you about the sp3 hybridization, the structure it has, the bond angle it has. If you have not seen that video, I will be uploading the card of YouTube so that you will be directed towards that video. Bond angle will be 109.5 degrees. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps that you have to do in every compound, so that it will be easier for you to draw the structure. Now you have written this sentence, you can write these 4 keywords in your sentences. Now just draw the structure. Don't forget to write all the things on the board before I drop it. Don't miss any key information. Yes. If you remember from the tetrahedral structure, I told you that suppose central atom is A and all the other single covalently bond atoms are B. It is the structure of tetrahedral. If you have learned this structure, it is no problem for you. Here the central atom is our carbon. And all the other 4 atoms are hydrogen. But this is not what is required. We have to draw structure on the basis of hybrid orbital theory. This is very easy. Once you have traced down the single covalent bond structure, just trace the hybrid orbital theory, that is double shaped hybrid orbitals. Trace it like this. It's nothing, it's very easy. And don't forget to elongate this bundle. I can draw it separately so that it will be easier for you to recognize carbon . One thing is left, that is hydrogen. Hydrogen has only one electron in its outermost shell, so the type of hybrid orbital will be the spherical. Hydrogen is one. Hydrogen will be one electron in its outermost shell. Now just draw our spherical shape to show the sigma bond between hydrogen and don't forget one thing that is very important, to show the bond angle 109.5. this is the complete structure of sp3 hybridization of CH4. If you have any query, you can write in the comment section below. Now we will be moving towards the sp2 hybridization. So now for the example of sp2 hybridization, I will be considering the example of the compound ethene. The molecular formula of ethene is C2H4. The first of all, write the basic step. The first step was to identify the central atom. Here the central atom will be the element which is least in number. Carbon is least in number, it is 2, and hydrogen is 4. So our central atom will be carbon. After the central atom, we write the structural formula of the compound. As you all know, carbon has 4 valencies. We have 2 carbon here, that is, we have 2 central atoms here. Carbon is covalently bonded with other carbon, and each carbon has 2 hydrogens. Getting my point? We have 2 carbon, we have 2 carbon. Each hydrogen, we have 2 hydrogen with each carbon. 2 hydrogen with each carbon. Just count to make sure that you have made the written the same and correct molecular formula. 4 hydrogen, 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 carbon, 1, 2, we have 2 carbon. But something is missing here. Since we know that carbon has a valency of 4, let's count that valency of carbon in this compound. For this carbon, 1, 2, 3. And for this carbon, 1, 2, 3. The fourth valency is missing, and that valency will form pi bond, that is double bond. Here we will be having pi bond. As I told you in the lecture number 1, what is pi bond? Pi bond is the double or triple bond, or the bond which is formed after the first or single covalent bond. In this two bond, double bonds, we have one sigma bond and the other one is pi bond. Let's say the upper one is pi bond and the below one is sigma bond. Now, after drawing the structural formula, the third step will be to count the number of sigma bonds. That will be telling us which type of hybridization is occurring in a compound. So, for counting the sigma bond here, as we have two central atoms, just divide the structure into two equal halves and consider any one of them. Because it is symmetric, it will be the same. Suppose I am considering the left structure, just count the number of single covalent bond. That is sigma bond. 1, 2, and the third, 3. Why we can't count this as 4? Because it is pi bond, it is not a single covalent bond. Do remember this. 1, 2, and 3. 1 is a sigma bond, but we cannot count the upper bond as it is pi bond, not a sigma bond. So we have 3 sigma bonds. What does 3 sigma bonds show? 1 less than the number of sigma bonds will be the type of hybridization occurring in your compound. 1 less than 3 is 2. So we are having sp2 hybridization. I think it's clear now. We have done two structures, how to count the number of sigma bonds and how to tell which type of hybridization is going to occur in your compound. Now that you have written that which type of hybridization is this, write the geometry of that type of hybridization. Geometry, as I told you, will be trigonal or plane triangular. Sometimes it is in plane triangular in some books, and the bond angle will be, bond angle short form BA is 120 degrees. Now let's move on to draw the structure of ethene. Remember trigonal structure, the central atom was A and 120 degrees apart all the single covalent bonded BAs. It was our triangular structure and the angle between them was 120 degrees. Here, as we have two central atoms, remember we have two A's, two central atoms, and both the central atoms are single covalently bonded with each other, as well as pi bond, double or triple covalent bond. So we will be having two structures like this in ethene. Remember, two central atoms, so two structures like this. So let's draw two structures. I am drawing directly the hybridization structure. Sorry for the drawing, I'm not perfect in it. Write carbon here. Three hydrogens will be here. That is sigma bonded. And spherical shape is for hydrogen. And it is got one central atom. And the second one will be drawn like this. So what is the mistake in this compound? As you can see, in C2H4, if I draw the structure again, both the central atoms are single covalently bonded with each other. But these compounds are not single covalently bonded with each other. What we have to do? Simply, we have to rotate it 180 degrees or 90 degrees. So that we can combine these two compounds single covalently. It will be easier for us. Now, one mistake I have done or done intentionally is that these, according to this structure, we have both the central atoms single covalently bonded with each other. But here, we don't have that type of scenario. So what is the mistake? I have to make single covalent bond between two central atoms. It's very easy. Just tilt this structure 180 degrees or you can say 90 degrees so that these two structures combine with single covalent bond. Nothing will be changing. It will be remain trigonal. It will be having 120 degree bond angle. The only thing will be changed is the orientation of the compounds. So for the orientation of the compounds, I am tilting this diagram 190 or 90. So now we will be tilting or shifting the hybrid orbital that we formed. This is the first central atom in the one of the two, and the same will be formed with the second. And now you can see both the central atoms are single covalently bonded as in the structure I have shown. So mention the sigma bond here, shade it, and hydrogen. Compare with your structures, 4, 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 4 hydrogens, and 2 carbon. Now one thing is missing, where is pi bond? everywhere it has vanished. For determining the pi bond and the structure that pi bond contains in a hybrid orbital theory, you have to understand sp2, the formation of sp2 hybrid orbital. As we all know, sp2 is formed by 1s and 2p hybrid orbitals. And what are those 2p hybrid orbitals? Px and py. So which hybrid orbital is left? Pz. Pz is unhybridized. In sp2, due to unhybridized pz orbital, we are left with pi bond. Pz unhybridized, pz orbital is unhybridized in sp2 hybrid orbital. So pz will form pi bond. Remember, what is pi bond? Pi bond is formed by the sideways overlapping, not head-on overlapping. It is called head-on overlapping. Okay, if these two carbon and hybrid orbitals are head-on collide with each other to form sigma bond, hydrogen and head-on colliding with carbon orbitals to form sigma bond. But pz overlaps sideways. Pz overlaps sideways. So now draw the pi bond. And how do we draw a pi bond in our structure? Remember, the orbital which is unhybridized is drawn with dotted lines. Pz is unhybridized. Draw Pz in dotted lines as it is. It is not taking part in hybridization. The orbital which has not taken part in hybridization forms the pi bond. Okay, now you can see they are overlapping sideways. So we can mention them as pi bond. I hope it's clear for you that how can you draw a pi bond. Now let's do the last sp hybridization. Now the last type of hybridization left is sp hybridization. For sp hybridization, I have an example of another organic compound, that is C2H2, ethyl, family of form alkyne. Again, all those steps will be there. First of all, central atom. Now the central atom that I told you in this lecture, they have both same number of elements in the compound, 2 carbon, 2 hydrogen. So what we will do, we will identify which element has greater atomic number. Certainly carbon has 6 and hydrogen is 1, so our central atom is carbon. Second, we have to draw the structure of ethyl. We have 2 central atom here like ethyne. We have 2 central atom here like ethyne. So we will draw 2 carbon, and each carbon contains 1 hydrogen. Now review, how many valency does carbon possess? Carbon has 4 valencies, but here if we consider 1 carbon atom, when we have 2 central atom, just consider 1, it is symmetric, it will be the same. We have 2 single covalent bond, 1, 2, but valency is not completed. To complete the valency, we have to draw double and triple covalent bonds. This is how the double triple covalent bond exists and comes into play in our chemical reaction. So if we draw double bond, it will be 3, and if we draw triple bond, it will be 4. Now count the valency for each carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now its valency is completely filled. 1, 2, 3, 4. From either side, the valency will remain same. Now that we have drawn the structure, we have to identify the number of sigma bonds. As you all know, the first bond that is formed in a chemical reaction is called sigma bond, and it is a single covalent bond. We have 1 and 2 single covalent bond. It is double bond, it is triple bond. So it certainly cannot be sigma bond. These are pi bonds. By the end of this lecture, I hope that you will be completely full of concepts about the pi bond and sigma bond and how do they come into play in a chemical reaction or hybridization. We have two pi bonds here and two sigma bonds here. Just count the number of sigma bonds. 1, 2. You can count on either side, it is symmetric. Just remember when you have two central atoms, take one into consideration. Two sigma bonds. When you have two sigma bonds, just less one from the sigma bond. 2 less than 1. 2 minus 1 will give you 1. And it is sp hybridization. Okay? One less from the number of sigma bonds. 2 sigma bonds, 1 less than 2, it's 1. If you can write it as sp1 hybridization or simply sp hybridization. Now that we have considered and find out the type of hybridization that is occurring in methane, draw the geometry. What geometry do we have? As we have discussed in the very first lecture, geometry is linear. And linear has always bond angle of 180 degrees. 180 degrees. Now shifting towards the drawing of the structure. First of all, the structure in covalent number 1. It was a linear structure with 180 degrees. Just follow the steps of covalent bond. Our structure would be like this, but since we have two central atoms, we will draw two structures. Remember, each carbon has one hydrogen. Let's draw the structure again so that we will be having the guidance from it. Each carbon has one hydrogen. So join one hydrogen with S-shaped orbital. And each carbon is single covalently bonded with each other. So each carbon is single covalently bonded with each other. Build the sigma bond. Now what about the pi bond again? Pi bond is missing. Shift towards sp hybridization. How sp hybridization is formed? One s orbital and one p orbital. And that is px. That's why it is linear. So which hybrid orbitals are left? Py and pz. Pz is unhybridized. So Py and Pz is unhybridized. These will form the pi bonds. Very easy structure. We will follow the same footsteps that we followed in ethene. Draw the Py. Remember, the orbital which does not take part in hybridization is drawn in dotted lines. You can call it Py or you can call it Pz. And the other one is Py and Pz. Say it Pz, say it Py, call it Pz, call it Py, sorry, and show a line to determine this pi bond. I hope by the end of this lecture you will be able to draw all types of structures. If I get time, I will upload some review questions of different compounds, which is all these compounds that I have discussed are all organic compounds. If I get time, I will upload a structure for review problems in which I will be discussing different types of other compounds, inorganic compounds even, so that it will be easier for you to make good marks in examination. See you in the very next lecture of ion electron method, in which we will be solving the ion electron method for acidic medium and basic medium in the easiest logics. Till then, take good care of yourself. And don't forget to subscribe and share this channel and the video so that maximum masses can be benefited from this. Thank you for watching your video. Till then, take good care of yourself.